Hello guys and welcome to Laravel 7 tutorials. So guys, in the previous video we successfully implemented the role based seeder and we successfully implemented our roles using this specific role based seeder in the database. So now we have two roles right here, admin and basic user. So everything is working fine. And in this video guys, we are going to implement the admin user seeder and we are going to use this specific seeder to create the admin user account, and that's it. And also we are going to change the redirection and we are going to attach the roles to our basic user and the admin user. So let's start without further talking. So first of all, what I'm going to do is, as you can see, I have already accessed my project directory right here and it's up and running. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to stop my project and I'm going to create a seeder. PHP artisan make seeder, and seeder name is, let's say, admin user seeder. Okay. So yes, seeder created successfully. Let's move to Sublime and I'm going to open my admin user seeder. So guys, we are going to use this seeder to create user, and this user will be basically, we are going to assign this specific user the role that is related to admin. In this example, let's say one. So what I'm going to do is, in order to create user, we need to import users class right here. So what I'm going to do, use app user, that's it. Okay, now what we can do is, let's move to this function and I'm going to create a variable user create, and let's say I want to create, actually let's access the database right here, user. Okay, so we need name, email and password column. It's I have accessed this lower database just because of you, so that we are on the same page, that we only need to create, let's say, name, email and password field. And since we are using Eloquent, so we will be creating the created at and updated at fields with the help, without doing anything. Basically, whenever we use Eloquent, we are going to fill these fields accordingly, whatever the date time, sorry guys. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, name, let's assign some name. So I'm going to put my name right here, and let's move forward, email, and let's say email would be my email, allaboutlaravel@gmail.com. let's move forward and let's put a password. And for the password, we need to do the encryption and it will be based on bcrypt. Okay, and let's put our password. Okay, so since it's the purpose of this video is just for testing, so yeah, I can show you the password, but don't share this type of password with anyone. Okay guys, just keep that in mind. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, we are using these lines, we are going to create our user. Now what we need to do is, we need to assign this user a specific role. So let's do that. User roles attach one, that's it. Okay, so now when we run this method, we are going to create a user, and this specific user is going to be saved right here in this variable. And I'm assigning this specific user, whoever I'm creating, the roles that is related to, or let's say where the ID is one. Just keep that in mind. Okay, so let's say if you are confused about this role, so I'm using this roles from right here, user.php. You know, we have implemented the relationship, right guys? So yeah, right here. Okay. Okay, so now what we can do is, let's run the seeder. PHP artisan db seed minus minus class flag, and let's say seeder name is admin user seeder. Okay, so database seeding completed successfully. Let's move to database and let's do a refresh on user. Okay, so now you can see we have successfully created our user, and you can see it's encrypted, and we are successfully creating the created at and updated at time, date and time fields right here respectively. Okay guys, so now let's say in any case, if any of you guys want to create multiple user or let's say multiple admin user, how can you do that? Simply you can use this code again and again, but the better way would be, let's comment this out and let me show you. Okay, so let's create a multi-dimensional array. So let's do admins is equals to, this is going to be an array, and since it is a multi-dimensional array, it can contains multiple arrays. So yeah, let's create another array, and in this case I want it to be, let's say I want to create name field once again. So let's do it like this, admin user name would be just like this. Let's put a space and let's create an email. Email would be, let's say, admin@gmail.com, and let's say password would be password once again, bcrypt 1234 1234. Okay, don't share your password with anyone guys. Okay, and yeah, that's it. So let's move right here. Okay, now what I need to do is, since this is one array in and it contains only one user related information, so let's say if in any case I want to create multiple, I can simply copy and paste since it is a multi-dimensional array. Okay, so name here would be, let's say, super admin. Okay, and let's make this a capital, and let's say super@gmail.com. Okay, yeah, so we have our multi-dimensional array. Now what we need to do is, we can simply use for each admins as admin. Okay, and now what we need to do is, since we need to assign the or attach the role to each of these admin, what we need to do is we need to create a variable right here as well. So yeah, we can do that without assigning a variable, but it's a better way, and I like this approach. So that's why admin user is equals to, and what we need to do is use user create, and since this is an array, so we can pass it right here. So $admin, that's it. You can see the procedure right here. So we are passing whole of this right here. Okay, so I hope you are not confused now. Okay, now what we can do is assign the role admin user attach, sorry, roles attach one. That's it guys. Okay, now what we need to do is simply run this seeder again. So yeah, let's do that. So I will use up arrow and enter. Okay, so I think I made a mistake. Yes, right here, sorry guys, I made the same mistake in the Urdu lecture as well, sorry for that guys. Okay, so I'm going to run this command again. Okay, so database seeding completed successfully. Now what I need to do is, let's see, let's refresh user, and now you can see we are able to create multiple admin user using the code right here. Okay, so I hope you liked it, and I'm going to keep both of them right here. Okay, it's for you guys. Okay guys, so now what we can do is simply try to log in. Let's do a login, because now is the time to test these users. Okay, so for that I need to run my project php artisan serve, and now let's do a refresh and let's try our user. Since it's an admin user login, that's why we are redirected to admin user dashboard. So our users are working perfectly fine. If you want to check the other two users, you can just go ahead. Okay, now what I need to do is, basically guys, I need to change the redirection for the basic user, because we are not assigning, let's say, let me open this Firefox, and I'm going to access my project right here as well. Okay guys, so using this register form, we are always going to create a basic user. So what we need to do is, while a user is creating his or her account, what we need to do is we need to attach a basic user role. So let's do that, and also we are going to change the redirection for the basic user. Why? Because we have implemented the logic on the let's say while the user is trying to log in, but once he is trying to create his credentials, like he is trying to sign up, we need to change the redirection there as well. So let's see that in action, and let's move to Sublime. I'm going to close this, and let's move to app, HTTP, controllers, auth, register controller. So guys, whenever first of all, let's discuss the procedure right here. First of all, we show our login form using this. Then let's say if some user is trying to register, he is going to type something right here, and when he click register account, we are going to move right here for the validation. Once the validation is done, we are going to move right here to this function, and it is going to create a specific user. Now what we need to do is we need to assign this specific user which we are creating in any case right here. We need to assign him or her a specific role. So let's do that right here. For that, I will remove return from here, $user. Okay. Now, whatever user I'm creating right here, I have it right here in the $user variable, and I can simply do this user roles attach. First of all, let me show you what I'm doing right here. I'm going to create a testing user. Okay, and for that I think, yeah, I need to cancel this, sorry guys, because I need to show you something what I am changing right here. So yeah, sorry, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, I'm trying to create a basic user since we are not assigning any sort of role. So you can see we are redirected to admin dashboard. Why? Once again, the reason is because we are not assigning any sort of role. So the basic redirection is to the dashboard. Okay, and we need to change that as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this redirection to user slash dashboard. Okay, now let's move forward, and I'm going to do the same procedure, $user, and let's assign this user a role. This was important so that everyone can understand like what we are doing right here. Okay, so attach a role, and sorry, not one, it is going to be two since it is a basic user. Now what we need to do is we need to return this user. That's it. Okay guys, now let's first of all, I'm going to delete the user, testing user I just created. I don't want any extra record for now in the users table. So yeah, operations, and in start increment from 4th ID. Okay, now let's move to Firefox. Let's access our project once again, and let's try to create an account now. Test, and let's say test@gmail.com, and password would be 1234 1234. Register. Okay guys, so now we are redirected to our user based dashboard, and let's try to access the admin dashboard. Okay, so not found. Everything is working like a charm. Okay, so that's what we were going to discuss. Okay guys, now one last thing right here. Since we are successfully assigning or attaching the role to the basic user and the admin user, the last thing what we can do is let's move to login controller, and let's define the same route or the same let's say URL for the basic redirection, initial redirection. Okay, right here in the login controller, we are going to redirect a specific user based on this right here, based on his role ID. Okay, so it should work perfectly fine. Let me try to log in once again so everything is clear. Okay, and don't forget to make this change right here as well. Okay, it's not necessary, but yeah, just do it please guys. Okay, it's not really necessary. If you are going to remove it, you can still be able to redirect based on your role. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to try to log in again just to show you that everything is working perfectly fine. Okay, so it's an admin user, we are redirected to admin dashboard, and since we have created a new user, we can test this once again. If you want to, you can simply create a new user as well. So login, and let's do, okay guys, so yes, everything is working for perfectly fine, and that's it guys, that's it from this video. And yeah guys, I just want to discuss one more thing, that is for the next video we are going to cover about page. Since we have created the CRUD, we are going to cover and we are going to put some data in the about, this about related section, contact related section, and the footer related section. So we are going to put some data and we are going to then display it on our front end. And yeah guys, one more thing that I want from you guys is you need to create some blog, using this, let's say, lorem ipsum text, or you can, if you want to, you can create your own. It's totally up to you. Okay, so in the next video, when I'm going to appear online, you are going to see some blogs created right here. I'm going to create some admin related blogs, some user related blog. I'm going to put some of them on, let's say, active status, and some of them would be, let's say, hidden. So yeah, just create some blogs so that we can carry on with the about, contact, and footer section. So that's it from this video guys, and I hope you guys like this video, you guys like the Cedar concept, and you guys like the redirection concept. So yeah, if you liked it, please like, subscribe, share. Thank you, take care, and yes guys, be ready, okay? Okay, take care.